As we know, Operation Scoby Curve was recently launched, and in collaboration with the Guyana Defense Force, the Guyana Police Force has continued to work together with that organization as a team for us in the first instance to sensitize members of the community of the importance of them adhering to the measures that are in place. So we need to engage, encourage, educate, and then enforce. We've been doing that, and we only hope that people will continue to adhere to the measures that are in place. So we would like to express thanks in a big way for this donation, this timely donation that we're going to receive today, not only for our ranks who are going about their business routinely on a day-to-day basis, but more importantly, those frontline ranks who are engaged in the operations and those who are in the regions as part of the task force that are on board the locations. We are also thankful because we've seen instances where members of society, members of the public, reported to the police stations to make complaints, and they were without masks. So once we have that, we also ensure that they're able to have a mask whenever they're making a report.
Responsible members of the population, and then we have a few members of the population that maybe we need to help to educate what the risks of COVID-19 are. The second part of what I'd like to say is that we want to encourage members of the public to respect and work with the police force on the public health ordinance. COVID-19 is a very serious pandemic that is affecting the world. And I think now we're into millions of deaths worldwide. And in Guyana, we're above 3,000 cases. We'd encourage all members of the population to follow the guidelines as set by the Ministry of Public Health, as well as the international agencies such as the WHO and PAHO, and to wear your mask and social distance. So again,